Golden year, and joining us today, Anton Du Beke. Hello.
Hello, my love. How are you?
I'm all right.
You're looking well.
I get away with it.
You're looking fine.
It's not too bad.
You've been working out.
I hold gauze up in front of my face. That helps a bit. Been working out.
Soften that focus, for goodness sake.
Anyway, you are a busy man these days.
Yes. Well, good, better that than the other, right?
Exactly. But not just Strictly, of course, which we know all about, but you've got a new book out. And this is not your first.
Yeah, no, this is the seventh in the series. This is... And I say this all the time because everyone goes, oh, well, if I haven't read the first one, I can't read this one. It's not the case. They're all standalone novels. But sort of think Agatha Christie and Poirot or Jack Reacher, which I absolutely love, by the way. This is the story of the Buckingham Hotel. It's called A Dance for a King. And it's set, we're now in 1942, so we're in the middle of the Second World War. And our intrepid hero, Raymond de Guise, has come back from fighting Rommel in Africa, come back to the hotel, the Buckingham Hotel. And I've always wanted to write a spy novel, an espionage novel. And the first novel I wrote, which I thought was very spy-y, because that's the thing, turned out to be nominated for a Romantic Novel of the Year award. And it was at that moment I realised it wasn't a spy novel at all. So ever since then, I've been trying to put more spy stuff in.
You're more Barbara Cartland than John Le Carré.
Sadly, yes. It was the chaise longue that did it. And so, but now I've got this love, I'm so delighted by it, this lovely sort of storyline going through where he is... essentially spying for the government on the things that are going on in the hotel, of which he is a demonstration dancer. But also there's a big do, a bigger event at the Royal Albert Hall towards the end of the book for the King, which he's going to be performing in. So all of those elements really are sort of, I mean, I love the Albert Hall. I've performed at the Albert Hall many times and it's my favourite place to perform in. So I wanted to do something like that. And I never got a chance to dance for the Queen. I've danced for every other member of the royal family and performed in front of them various things. In actual fact, when the King was the mere prince, I performed for him. But I'd love to perform, do something, maybe at the Albert Hall, for the King. So it is
it's a wish sort of, fulfillment.
Yes, it is. It's a sort of, and it feels like synergy because at the time, you know, 1942, the King and was a major part of the war with Winston Churchill and the country. He was that sort of solid foundation. And I feel it's sort of, we now have a new King on the throne.
Completing the circle.
Yes.
Right. How do you find plotting? Is that does that come easily to
you? That's my favourite bit.
Because that's vital, isn't it, in a piece like this?
It's like a big stream of consciousness with me. So for example, I was with my publisher yesterday and I was doing this. Mm-hmm. I've got an idea. What I'd like is for this and then that. And it's what I call sort of an overview, really. I get this sort of an overview. And I do the same when I'm choreographing and creating sort of shows and stuff like that. It's all visual for me and it's all sort of physical. And that's the way I do it, really. And then I get this overview and then I can sort of add the nuts and bolts. Right. George Balanchine used to do the same thing when he used to choreograph. He used to work from the highlights down.
Right.
So he used to work with all the big moments, create that and then work his way down.
And fill in.
Everything else would be filled in from that point on.
But you have to sort of be able to, in dance as well as in writing a plot, you've got to stand back and see the big picture.
That's the thing. I have to realise as well, this is a thing I found out early doors. This was a thing I had when I was in the studio. I'm not doing this for me specifically. So what I might love, if it feels great, my old teacher used to say, if it feels great, it might not look any good. And this is how this sort of been with me forever, really. Just because it feels great doesn't mean it looks any good. So, and it's the same with when I'm creating sort of storylines. Just because I think it's amazing, I can see my editor's face going, Just one more time with that? Okay.
So you've got all this going on, but you're a family man as well. So.
Well, Hannah, my wife and the children, the twins are seven, excuse me, and Hannah's great as well, because Hannah, actually, she did English at university and classics, and you should see our library at home. It's just, it's our library, a bookshelf at home, and it's got Beowulf, and it's just all this stuff. So she's tremendous. She was a voracious, voracious reader growing up as well. So I you know, I throw ideas at her and go, what do you think of this? And she'll either give me a sort of thumbs up or invariably a thumbs down.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I won't run with that idea.
No, you do need somebody to do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's look back at your golden year. You've gone for 1979.
Yes.
Big year for you?
Well, it was really. I was thinking about it and I thought, well, that's a big year for me because that was when I started ballroom dancing. It's when I first walked into a studio and sort of that was the beginning of the rest of my life, if you like. Oh, it sounds quite dramatic. I should have written that down. So I felt that was sort of a great place to go. I think it was, do you know, the point is, I think it was 79, but it might have been 80. But we'll go with 79.
Yeah, that's close enough.
Close enough.
For jazz, as they used to say. Well, the first song you've gone for is Our Friends Electric, Gary Numan, Tubeway Army.
Well, I have to tell you this, because that was I haven't been to many concerts in my life. Do you know what it is? It's just the crowds. It's the getting in and the getting out that puts me off. There's nothing like being in I prefer theatres to big sort of arenas, you know. And there's nothing like being in a room with live music. But the first concert I ever went to with my oldest friend, who was a bit massive Gary Numan fan, and we went, I think it was the Hammersmith Apollo, it felt like. I mean, this is 100 years ago. And we went to see Gary Numan, and Our Friends Electric was a huge song. I mean, it was terribly, terribly exciting.
We'll relive that. That's lovely. Our Friends Electric, Gary Numan, Tubeway Army, and Anton Du Beke are still feeling the excitement of that back in 1979.
I remember everyone was dressed up like Gary Numan. It's the first time I ever experienced people dressing up in the gear and stuff. Do you know, I was terribly excited.
Next is going to be The Jam, another great favourite.
Yeah, I loved The Jam growing up, which is interesting because, you know, as someone who loved sort of ballroom dancing. And that sort of music. The Jam, I just thought, and I still think, you call them a guitar band, I suppose, don't you? Would you call them a guitar band in that sort of way? Sort of, I still think they're probably one of the best of that ilk that there's ever been, really. We had a renaissance with it all in sort of the 90s, you know, with bands like Oasis and then through the end into the 2000s, we had became more popular again. But I still think few stand up to some of the Jam stuff. I just thought it was just brilliant.
The Jam, Eton Rifles. Anton Du Beke choosing his golden year, 1979. What age did you start dancing? Was it?
Well, I was obviously one or two in 79. No, I was 13 or 14, something like that. So it was around that time. It was about 79, 80 sort of time.
Difficult? Because, you know, most young guys don't go to dance lessons or do dancing. So did you have to sort of square up to anybody?
I just remember this. I was about that age, and you're right, boys didn't go dancing, and it was proven when I walked into the it was a church hall. My sister went, and it was summer holidays, and I went along to meet her because it was, you know, trying to find bored, funny things to do. So I went along to meet her, and as I walked into the church hall, it was a room full of girls. You know, it was forever thus. And I sat and watched, and then, of course, being the only boy, or a boy, in the vicinity, the dance teacher pulled me up onto the floor and said, come on, have a go at this. And I was, you know, I would just say yes to everything because I couldn't say no because I didn't want to. Oh. So, yeah, oh, okay. And then off, and I, but you know, I loved it immediately. The worst thing to do for anybody wanting to dance is say freestyle. You just see people running for the hills when you go freestyle, especially a fella. Fellas don't do freestyle. We need choreography. We need direction.
No, tell me about the direction of Strictly this year. I know as a judge you can't really pick out anybody, but is there anybody, even at this early stage, we should be keeping an eye on?
I'm still blown away by Chris.
Yeah.
I just was fascinated to see how it was going to work. Now, and dancing is so visual because I'm going to show you what I want you to do.
Yeah.
That doesn't work with Chris. So now, if you close your eyes and I teach you how to dance, how are you going to learn? But you just the words. Well, the words don't mean anything.
No, move
and
this,
feel.
Move that. Yeah.
You're going to have to shove your foot forward. Now, I would have grabbed hold of him, put him in hold, and not let him go for a second. I mean, Diane's doing upside down handstands and grabbing, and he's playing the guitar on her leg. the most, I have to tell you, it's one of the most extraordinary things I've ever seen on Strictly Come Dancing. I take my hat off to them. If I could have given them 47, I would have done it.
We'll get a new paddle made up for
them. Definitely a new crisp paddle. I just think it's the most amazing thing I've ever seen.
Indeed. Sister Sledge, you've gone for, and this title, He's the Greatest Dancer.
Well, it's not for me to say, but Ken, if you say it, then it must be true.
I've said it. There it is. Anton, lovely to see you. Massive success with the book, A Dance for the King, it's called, and we'll see you on Strictly.
Well, bless you.
Thank you.